In this video, we will learn about our famous quantum algorithm known as Shor's algorithm. Given a number n, which is composed of two prime numbers, say u and v, Shor algorithms find prime factors of number n in polynomial time. In contrast, if we have to find prime factors of a number n, then on a classical computers, it takes exponential time. Therefore, on classical computers, we are able to use a famous cryptography algorithm known as RSA. RSA security is based upon a one-way function, which is integer factorization. And because Shor algorithms can find integer factorization in a polynomial time, so RSA will be nullified or will be useless when a fully powered and fully working quantum computer is realized. This video is divided in four steps. First of all, I will talk about some number theory and basic mathematics that is used by the Shor algorithm. Secondly, I will discuss the basic idea, the key idea of the Shor algorithm. Then I will properly write all the steps of the Shor algorithm. And finally, we will do an example so that all those steps are clear to us. So let's start. I will start with mathematical background that is needed to understand Shor algorithm. This is basic number theory, so you might already be aware of that, but I still want to repeat those things so that everybody can understand. We must know about modulus arithmetic. Is congruent to 2 in mod 3. So basically we are saying that in the universe of mod 3, 20 is same as 2. It is because when we divide 20 from 3, our remainder is 2. So sometimes we call modulus arithmetic as remainder arithmetic because we're talking about remainder. So 20 divided by 3, our remainder is 2. Similarly, I can write it like 2 is congruent to 20 in mod 3. The reason I've written mod 3 in bracket is because mod 3 is with right hand side as well as with the left hand side. Similarly, I can also write this as 20 mod 3 is congruent to 2. Secondly, we must know about divisibility rules. So if I say that A is congruent to 0 in mod n, then it implies that n divides A. So let's do an example of this. So I can say that 32 is congruent to 0 in mod 2. That means if I divide 32 by 2, my remainder will be 0. Or I can say that 2 divides 32. We should also be aware about order of a group. So given a number n and x, order of a group is a number r. Order is the smallest positive number r such that x raised to power r is congruent to 1 in mod n. Let's do an example to make this concept crystal clear. in this example, my n is 17, my x is 2, and I have to find order r. So basically, I have to use above equation. That means 2 raised to power r is congruent to 1 in mod 17. I will try different values of r from 1, 2, 3, so on, such that for the smallest value of r, my 2 raised to power r is congruent to 1 in mod 17. After some calculation, my r is equals to 8. The algorithm of finding order on classical computer is exponential. But we will be using a quantum algorithm to find order, and that algorithm I will explain in the next video. We are done with our background. We have learned basic mathematics that is needed to understand Shor. Now we will try to learn the key idea behind Shor algorithm. So our key idea of Shor algorithm. Recall that for the Shor algorithm, our input is a composite number n. And n is composed of two primes u and v. Our goal is to find u and v such that n is equals to u times v. So what Shor algorithm do is that it use order finding algorithm as a subroutine. So Shor algorithm by itself is a classical algorithm based upon simple number theory, but it calls order finding algorithm to find order, which find order in polynomial time. So it takes a random x, and for that random x it find order r such that x raised to power r is congruent to 1 in mod n. This n is our input, our composite number. And then it checks if our r is even or odd. If our r is even, then I can write this equation as x raised to power r over 2 whole square minus, I take this one to this side, minus 1 whole square is congruent to 0 mod n. Then I can just expand this, so it will become x r over 2 minus 1 times x r over 2 plus 1 is congruent to 0 mod n. These square root of x will be either trivial or non-trivial. By trivial, it implies that x raised to power r over 2 will be equal to plus minus 1. And in case of non-trivial, x raised to power r over 2 will not be equals to plus minus 1. If these square roots are non-trivial, then they will be multiple of u and v. That means this might be a times u, and this might be b times v. In order to retrieve u from this or v from this, we can take GCD of this with n. So GCD, greatest common divisor of x raised to power r over 2 minus 1 comma n will give me u. And then to find v, I simply divide n by u, and that will be my v. So in short, I have to first use order finding quantum algorithm to find order r, and then I have to check if my order is even or not. When my order is even, then I can write this equation in this way in two different square roots. And then I have to check if my square roots are trivial or not. And when my square roots are non-trivial, then I can retrieve my factors of n by taking GCD of x raised to power r over 2 minus 1 with n. So now let's write all of those steps clearly, and then we will do an example to make everything crystal clear. So let's clear the board and write the Shor algorithms properly. Shor's algorithm. We start with an infinite loop. The loop starts from here and loop ends here. Only way we can leave the loop when we find our answer and we return. Step one is that we choose randomly x from 2 to n minus 1. N is our input. We want to factorize n. Step 2. Now, in very rare case, in 1 in trillion chances, we could be extremely lucky and x could be our factor of n. So let's check that. If d equals to GCD of x comma n is greater than equals to 2, then this is the case, then we are extremely lucky and by some chance we have found a factor of x by luck. So we just say that u will be equals to d because we have found a factor, and v will be equals to n over u, and we return our u and v. So this is the end of our if condition. Step 3. Otherwise, we will find r such that x raised to power r is congruent to 1 in mod n. Here we are calling our quantum subroutine of order finding algorithm. This will be the subject of next video. 4. Now we have if condition. If r is even and d equals to GCD of x raised to power r over 2 minus 1 comma n is greater than equals to 2. So the first condition is checking that our order is even, and when our order is even, then we are checking the second condition. In the second condition, we are checking if our square root of r is trivial or not, because if our square root of r is non-trivial, only then our GCD will be greater than or equals to 2. When our square root is non-trivial and r is even, then we once again return u equals to d, and we return v equals to n over u. So that is the end of our algorithm. Now let's do an example to make it even more clear. In this example, my n is 221. I have to find factors of 221. So I do my first step. My x is equals to 5. Now I'll do my second step, that I check if x is by any chance a factor of n, and GCD of 5 and 221 is equals to 1. That means this if condition will be false and I'm not lucky. So I have not found by chance a factor of n. Now I am at step three. I will find order of x. So I have to find 5 raised to power r mod n, which is 221 congruent to 1. And by calling my order finding algorithms, I find my r equals to 16. So I found my order equal to 16. Now I'm at step 4. In step 4, I have to check if my r is even. Yes, indeed, my r, which is 16, is even. Secondly, I have to find GCD of x raised to power r over 2 minus 1 and n. So my D will be that I find GCD of x, which is 5 raised to power 8, because r over 2 will be 8, r is 16, minus 1, comma 221. And my GCD came out to be 13. So I have found one factor of 221. Now to find the other factor, let's say this factor is named as u. To find v, I divide 221 by 13. And then my v will be equals to 17. So I found my other factor. Then I return 13 and 17. My u is equal to 13, my v is equal to 17. So that is it for this video. In the next video, we will learn about order finding algorithm, which is the quantum part of Shor algorithm. So I hope to see you around.